Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Ridler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Tuesday, and I'm feeling like I look rather serious today for a summer's day, but it's cool. So, how are you this Tuesday? What is your creative life looking like as you cast forward into the week ahead? What creative gems can you see or make room for? Are you going to do a little drawing this week, a little painting, a little collage, a little dancing, a little crochet, maybe cook up something new? What is inspiring you right now? I am definitely, my energy is going towards two main things right now. One is that we actually look like we have the go-ahead to do our renovation. Yay! And we had this moment of incredible excitement. The timing was so beautiful. Last week, as you know, I shared with you all how busy it was, what a time I've been through. And then everything sort of closed off, which was awesome. And the Friday night, I scheduled the newsletter to go, and then I was complete. And literally the next morning, we got the news that we are good to go for our reno. So it was amazing, and we were so excited, and it lifted this weight off our shoulders about whether we were going to be able to do it. But then very quickly it turned into, this is a huge project, and we have to move. We have to do it. So my mind is right now in windows. What kind of windows would we like to have? And what do windows say? And how do windows work? And it's a great reminder, too, of how often in our creative lives, in design, in theater, in a lot of art, in sculpture, there's this dance between the practical, what will work, what will actually work, what do we need in order for this to function the way we want it to function, and then what do we want it to say, how do we want it to say that, the sort of artistic voice piece. But you know, I think often artists are underestimated because they have a reputation, we have a reputation for being flighty or dreamers. Yay, we are dreamers. You know, we live in our imagination. But in truth, for any art to make it from the world of imagination and ideas into a tangible, practical piece in the world, there are all sorts of problems to be solved, choices to be made, tangible things to work with. There are always limitations. So anybody only has so much time, so much energy, so much money, so much space, so many resources. You can only have so many paints, so many canvases, so much studio space. I know we always dream of more, but everyone creates within some parameters. And then there's a million choices to make, red or blue, left or right, 6x6 or 36x36. Do you walk in stage left or do you walk in stage right? Would it be better if that song ended on a rise or a dip? All of these are decisions that have to be made, choices that are made by the artist, saying yes to something and no to something else so that something can take form. If we don't make choices, if we don't make decisions, if we don't get practical, if we don't work within the resources that we have, nothing gets made. And that would be a tragedy, because not only does nothing get made, but whatever is in our hearts wanting to be expressed just kind of sits there waiting. It's like there's this film living in your heart and nowhere to project it on. So it's just sort of these colors that sort of fly around you, which is beautiful, but it never takes form for you and the world to see it. And there's something about that taking form process that matters in many ways. And one of them is that it gives you confidence, right? The more you take something from in here and turn it into, you do the magic, the creative magic of turning it into a thing. It can be a sketch. It can be a poem. It can be anything. It can be a riff. a flower arrangement. But then you can stand back and look at that and go, I made that. That was my thought. That was my vision. Those were my choices. Those were my picks. And I think that's exactly why we get scared to do it too. Because what if we don't like it? What if other people don't like it? Then that may weigh heavily on our hearts. All of those are my choices and I don't like it. All of those are my choices and everybody thinks it sucks. But I really believe this in a deep and powerful way. Your creative spirit can make no wrong choices. There will be physical, tangible things as a human being. There's skills to hone. There's logic to follow. There's the way the resources work to understand. And that's just some of the skill we gain from what? Experience. We cannot gain our skills without doing. Without doing it wrong, without doing it messy, without experimenting, without making mistakes. But then our soul choices, when we honor them, because often we'll adjust. You know, we'll adjust because we'll think, blue will be more popular. You know, and when you're running a business, this is something you might think about. But when you're creating, just trying to express the truth of your soul in a something, the more real, the more authentic, the more honest, the more true, just true to your heart, yourself, and your own choices, the more alive, vibrant, and unique the piece will be. So it's brave, it's scary, it's exciting, it's adventurous, it's playful. The whole gamut of human life experience can take place through the creation of anything, the creation of any of our art forms. And it will always be this balance between the world of imagination and the real world, the tangible world. And sometimes, if we're lucky, we will achieve moments of rare and beautiful transcendence. You know, maybe you've been at a concert or seen a piece of art where you just got it, where you felt like something was transmitted from the universe through the artist to your deep spirit. And that is spectacular and rare. It's not something we expect, but it's something we lay the foundations for. And we do that by being as true to the spirit of the work and ourselves as possible, and then engaging with the practical with as much diligence, respect, and skill as we have in this moment. Perhaps that's a little lofty thinking for a Tuesday summer morning. To go from windows to transcendent art is kind of hilarious.
But maybe, in fact, this is one of the things I just truly love about art, is the way that the same principles apply, whether we are sitting at our kitchen table, making a collage or working in our art journals, or whether we are making a living as an artist and we have our own studio and it's filled with canvases and that's what we're working on. All of us are finding that way of taking the world of imagination and ideas and transmitting it into the world of being human and physical and tangible. And that just strikes me as such a, as I say it, it had never occurred to me before what a spiritual thing that is, because are we not living our lives like that? We are spiritual beings finding our way in physical, tangible bodies during our time here on Earth. And there's no sense fighting with one another. There is only joy or forward momentum when we find a way to make peace with one another, and we find a way to, as best as we can, solve the challenge of taking the ineffable, the spiritual, the internal, the imaginative, and turning it into, we're alchemists, turning it into gold. That is what is on my mind this morning. Windows and creative alchemy.
And hey, I was also thinking this morning, I know I've got an invitation out to you all to send me a self-portrait this summer. So I would love to fill the bulletin board with the self-portraits of people who watch the BTS. It would be such a joy. And the address is always at the end of the show. But also to remember, I love getting emails with a photo of where you watch the BTS. So make sure that the BTS is visible on your iPad or on your computer or on your TV. And then give us a sense of where you are watching. Are you watching on your lunch at work, or, you know, just at work? Are you watching before you head out? Are you taking a quiet moment on a Sunday morning to watch? And send it to me. And please include your name and also where you are in the world. I also love connecting and feeling like I know that there's you out there in Spain, and you out there in Portland, and you out there in Winnipeg. It just fills my heart with such joy. And what I love to do too is share them all at the end of the season. And so I'll include details for that as well, because I like to see, I like to connect with you. And so please send that along too. I'll share it during the season too, but then at the end we'll do sort of a gathering, like a celebration. That is it for me today. I am going to be working on getting an episode of Start out for you all. My sisters and I recorded yesterday, so we'll be getting that ready to go. You know, you can listen to it in a podcast too. Shannon always prepares that, and it's actually ready. She's faster than me. I'll leave a link to that. And also, I've got some videos that I'm working on of people sharing their experience with the studio yearbook. So if you've been thinking about investing in a summer yearbook and letting it be your companion in your studio this summer, maybe this will help you know whether it is for you. I hope it is. It is a ton of fun. It becomes a great creative practice, one that really holds your heart and reminds you of the preciousness of your life. And I guess that's on my mind too. Have a great week in your studio. Remember, your life is your studio, and I will see you